I decided to put some video that I had up because I discovered that other videos here on YouTube for repairing this particular lens were really just for fun watching and not a real tutorial. Also, I didn't see anything specifically on the frozen up zoom on this Canon 17 to 85 millimeter. And it seems to be a fairly common issue. A couple of suggestions as we get going. Make sure you have good tools. Nothing fancy is needed, but just make sure that you have the right sizes of things so that it fits and works and doesn't damage something. Lay out a piece of soft white cloth to put things on in order as you take them off. Important to do that. Makes it a little easier to put things back together. Remove the lens hood if necessary, and then set it down with the camera side up. This black ring inside the camera body mount is the first thing to take care of. I do it a little differently than I've seen it done before, but this seems to work good and avoids breaking the little tabs. There's four little tabs that just snap that ring in there, and if you press gently but firmly, it'll snap off. And you lift it out. With the plastic ring out of the way, you can now remove the two screws that hold in the electrical contacts to the camera body, not the stop over there to the left, just the two screws are right on both ends of the electrical contacts. Very, very little screws. Remove those and set them aside. Once that's done, then you can remove the four screws that hold in that camera body mount, bayonet mount, four screws that hold that in, and lift it off. Now the black plastic housing over and around the printed circuit board is loose, but don't take it off yet. There is one ribbon connector between the printed circuit board and the inside of that housing. On the printed circuit board, pull the ribbon directly back from how it goes in to the connector, and then remove the housing. Now there are something like five ribbon or flexible cable connections to contacts on the printed circuit board. These come out quite easily. Like the first one, you pull directly out from the right way the ribbon goes into it, just pull back on it and it'll slip out. A friction type of connection. Two of them have a hinged connector. They're right beside each other with kind of a brown trapdoor lid on them. You put a little screwdriver or a blade under the top edge of it on the side the ribbon goes in and flip it up. And it hinges up and then the ribbons can be just lifted out. Some of these ribbons have notches or shoulders right next to the connectors where they go in. You could put something pointed like a toothpick on both sides into those notches and pull back and they'll slide out. Or very, very miniature pliers or tweezers, but you want to be careful not to use something sharp or in any way scratch these ribbons because those are electrical conductors inside there. When all the ribbon cables are loose and the ends are sticking up in the air, there is one screw that you can remove in order to lift off the printed circuit board. Just like the process of disconnecting the ribbon cables, you don't need to see this next step one item at a time. It's pretty straightforward and hard to see through fingers. But this is what it looks like once the PC board is off. And if you look carefully, you'll see two rings, an inner and a outer plastic ring. Take six screws off of the outer plastic ring that holds it on. Look at the different shaped tabs as they go in and out and remove those six screws and then remove that outer plastic ring. With the outer black plastic ring removed, you can remove the six screws that hold the inner circle. Now you need to remove the wide rubber grip from the zoom barrel. Slide a very thin screwdriver under it without overstretching it, and then work it off. Now that this band around the lens barrel has been exposed, turn it until you find a square of black tape-like structure. Lift an edge of that and remove it completely. This will expose a hole with some electrical contact fingers in it, held with one screw. Here is a close-up of where the screw was, and just to its left is where the electrical contacts were. Removing them protects those little fingers of contacts from easily being damaged. Now look just to the left of that hole and find the first of three screws in sliding slots. They have little rings around them, standoffs. You need to remove all three of those. Now you can lift the outer casing from over the inner lens body. This will give you access to the screws that have caused the problem you're trying to fix. These screws, you will see a angled slot coming up to them from inside the lens. You need to snug those up. And then, once you've done all three of those nice and snug, fix them so they won't get loose again by putting Loctite or even just fingernail polish, as I'm doing here. Okay, your fix is done. Of course, you have to put it back together, but I'm going to leave you on your own to do that, which is why you laid things out so nice and in order as they came off. A couple of thoughts, however. As you put the outer casing back over the inner, ensure that there's a two-prong fork, and it needs to go over a tab that's deep inside the inner lens body. And then be sure that the manual focus ring drops down on its positioning pin. Just spin it around until it drops into place. And everything else pretty much comes in reverse order. Be sure that the ribbon cables are coming out in the proper positions so that you can reconnect them by the time the PC board is back in place. Some of them go through and under and over and that kind of thing. Then when it's all put back together, be sure to clean the glass lenses very well with the proper lens cloth, etc., so you don't damage it, both the outer and the back lens elements, because they probably have fingerprints all over them. And enjoy your restored lens. You just saved $250.